Didn't eat too much. I'm quite sure you did eat quite a bit yesterday, but I know I ate quite a bit yesterday. But it is a blessing to be here. It truly is a blessing, once again, from God that he enabled us to be here once again. And I just want to truly tell you that I'm glad to see you and that I love you. And welcome. Welcome to the Lord Fellowship. If there in the building. Let us bow our heads and have a word of prayer. I would like to ask if anyone walking, would they please be still? Merciful Fathers, once again we come to say good morning to you. We tell you, Father, that we just want to say thank you, Father. Thank you for allowing us once again to see another day. And we ask, O merciful Father, that you would just forgive us our sins and transgression. We ask, Father, that you would just have mercy on us, for we need your mercy this morning. We ask, Father, that you will bless each and every one here, each and every family that is represented here. We know you already have, Father, by allowing them to see another day. But, Father, we just ask that you would just continue to be with us all day long and to help us to show you and us to someone that's living in a dark, dark world. Father, let us help us to show our light. Father, that someone will want to be saved. Then we ask, O merciful Father, that you would just have your way with us. Help us to worship you in spirit and in truth, Father. Help us, Father, to do all those things that's pleasing in your sight. To be a lively Christian, Father. Not sit down and just in the pews, but enjoy you today. Just open up our hearts and minds to your word, Father, and to the worship service. This prayer I pray in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
Good afternoon. We'll be reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 31 through 39. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He that spared not his son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not also with him freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ Jesus that died, yea, rather, that was raised from the dead, who is at the right hand of God and also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulations or anguish or persecution or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword. Even as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long, we were accounted as sheep for slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is Christ Jesus our Lord. That's our scripture for today.
Come on, put those hands together. Bless God this afternoon. Come on, we can do better than that. Those hands together. If you know he's been good to you, if you know he brought you through the week, come on, it could have been the other way. Come on, let me start right there. Let me let everybody get in. Glory, glory. Come on. Hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, oh, glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, glory, glory, hallelujah. Come on, put those hands together. Said, I am climbing Jacob's ladder. Since I lay my burden down, Lord. Burden down, Lord. Since I lay my burden down. Burden down, Lord. Burden down, Lord. Burden down. Let me see you clap your hands.
Come on.
Let me see you clap your hands. Let me see you clap your hands. Whoa. Oh, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, oh, every round goes higher and higher. Since I laid my burden down, do I have a witness this morning? That every round goes higher and higher, since I laid my burden down. I say glory, glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down. Glory, glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down.
Thank you.
But if God done did something for you, you ought to stand on your feet and give God the glory. He's been too good.
Anybody got a praise today? Does anybody have a praise today? Let me see what it has.
How many of you know? dark room. He'll be your friend when you're friendless. He's Jesus. When I don't see one, he keeps me, even when I couldn't keep myself. Help me call him. Help me call him. Help me call him. Jesus, Jesus. There's power in the name. Power in the name.
To get excited about the name of Jesus. Amen, amen. We thank God for this music ministry leading us in worship, and we thank God for each and every one of them. We are so glad to see each and every one of you here today, and after you have eaten your ribs and your chicken, it's so good to see all of you to come to worship God in spirit and in truth. And we are so glad to see each and every one of you. If you're a first-time guest here, we want you to know that you're very special to us, and we want you to just slip your hand up and let us know who you are. And so we want to just love on you for a minute and just thank you for coming our way. If there are any guests in the house, y'all gonna have to turn these lights up, because I can't see you now. My glasses are already tinted. Y'all can't do me like that.
And I can't see that far. So y'all got to, I can't even see the folk. All right. Thank y'all so much. Thank y'all. I know y'all trying to keep it cool and all that kind of stuff, but I got to see. I need to see who I'm talking to. Amen. Listen, at this time, if we don't have any guests, let's just stand and fellowship with one another at this time and tell each other how good we are, how good it is to see each other at this time. Come on, let us stand. The choir will give us some music as we do that very quickly. Come on, let's stand and tell somebody God loves them and you love them too, and you're blessed to see them and you're blessed to have them here today. Amen. All right. Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much. Listen, just a few announcements. Brother James, come here very quickly. Brother James, come on. You thought I was going to make your announcement for you? You're going to do it. Listen, Brother James, if you need a job, and I'm talking about you need a job, because when you need a job, it don't matter what you have to do. If you need a paycheck, you need a paycheck. All right? And we have to learn how to use the resources that we have available to us. Brother James is hiring, and he's going to tell you where he's hiring and how you need to look and what you need to fill out. Right? All right.
Right. tomorrow, Bama Dine is having a job fair out at on the university. You can go to the website, bamadining.com. And contact us, and you can put a you can put your information online. It starts at 8:30 to 11:30 tomorrow. Looking for people in the food who can do food. There's other opportunities out there. And again, I tell everybody, when you put your foot in the door, you know the door opened up to other things that you can do out there. So if you got children, you got somebody who needs some part-time work, need to come out there and try to apply for a job, and it's what you put in and what you get out of it, okay? All right.
Thank you, my brother. Come on, give him a hand, Brother Ross, a hand. Excellent chef. If you need some cook, talk to him. He can cook it, amen. Thank God for him. Listen, just a few announcements. Of course, Sunday school is 11 a.m., Wednesday night services, 6 p.m. prayer, and youth crew fellowship, 6:30 Bible study, all right? And live youth stream for Bible study and Sunday worship. I want to thank our IT team for all that you are doing to help us do what we need to do to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ all over this land. We are grateful to you. Also, information, news and information is available on our Facebook page and our website at obctuscaloosa.org. And you can also give online 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And so you can do that. You don't have to wait till Sunday. You can do that before, whenever you want to. Also, our radio broadcast is every Sunday at 5 p.m. on 107.3 FM, 104.3 FM, and 1280 AM. Also, our daily prayer conference call is at 6:30, 7 days a week, 6:30 a.m., 7 days a week. All right, our deacons training is complete, and we thank God for our deacon candidates, and we want them to stand. All of our deacon candidates stand. Some of them are here, some of them are not, some of them out of town. Brother Tucker, wave your hand in the back. Brother Tucker, amen. That's his wife, Holly. All right. thank you. They have done such an excellent job, and we will have communion and deacon appointments next week. Now, let me explain something about what we're doing, because we have been taught wrong that once you're a deacon, you always a deacon. That's not true, because it's just like me saying, once I'm a pastor, I'm always a pastor. If I do something that is unbecoming of a pastor, I need to be removed. Amen? Amen? So nobody has a lifetime appointment, all right? And so what we're doing, we're starting off right, and this is the way that we're going to go. These deacons will be appointed for 2 years, right? 2 years at the time, and we evaluate. I will read the scripture. I got scripture to back this up. The Bible says that when you have desire the office of a deacon, that you use the office. And anytime you use something, when you're done using it, what you do? Turn it back in. Okay, I'm talking better than y'all responding. All right? And so we're not doing deacon's ordination. We are doing deacon's appointment. They will be appointed for this work. And I have already explained to them in the class that if they get mad at me and go to another church, they're only a deacon at this church. And they may have to go through it again, all right? And so we want you to understand that your deacon appointment does not travel from one church to the next, right? And so it's an appointment to do work. And what are deacons? Deacons are assistant pastors. It's their job to help me shepherd the flock, right? And so that's what we are doing. And so I thank God for all of them. We have some good men that are coming out. I thank God for them, and we're excited about that. Also, we have one that we'll that is already ordained along with Deacon Pruitt that we will appoint to some work, right? Also, our Full Gospel Church Fellowship International Conference in New Orleans is about 9 days away. Are you excited? I'm excited about what God is about to do, and we're excited about that. Listen, Sister Parker, we'll have an itinerary, and all of you saying what time you leaving, and here's the thing now. Let me say this. Let me go and put this. My finance team didn't tell me to say this, but some of y'all feeling some type of way because we leaving Friday morning because you want to hear Jakes. Let me tell you, you ain't paying for the bus. The church paying for the bus. All right? So as my mama used to say, you got to leave when your ride leave. Okay, then. Okay. You got it. Because when your ride ready to go, you got to be ready to go. All right? And so we have made a sacrifice to make that available for our members that want to go. We did not charge a dime for you to ride. And so the church is going to pick up that bill. And so I understand you can watch Jake's in your house. All right? You'll be back in time enough that you can watch Jake's in your house. All right? And so I don't want you to feel some type of way or be mad. If you want to stay, you can drive. That's what you can do. But Friday, after checkout time, the bus is going to be headed back to Tuscaloosa. Right? So I just want us to understand that and understand that we ain't going because we saved. We going on a dollar, all right? And it costs to go up and down the road. So I just wanted to put that in for free. Also, listen, youth, listen. It's going to be awesome. I'm excited for our children. I saw something online, and I may sneak over to the kids' zone. The kids going to have their own area with all kind of stuff, rock climbing and all kind of stuff. And so that we have some forms that need to be turned in to our youth director, Sister Ree Rylands, and that will be a brief meeting after service in room 105 so we can give you some very, very important information. So you got to sign off on some things so you won't sue the fellowship, all right? Also, the youth ministry quarter drive is going great. I want to thank our youth for what they are doing. As you, some of you don't know, we have adopted Clara Verna Towers, some sweet, sweet silver warriors over there. I'll be preaching to them this afternoon at 5:00 over there, and we have adopted them and our children. I did not know, as Sister Braggs was giving me a tour of the facilities and all that kind of stuff, I did not know that even in a place of that, that they had to pay for their own laundry. And And these folk are on a fixed income. And I said, okay, so this is a project for that we can do as an outreach. And so our youth are in competition, and so we thank God for what they're doing. And so it's going well. And so we want you to donate to our youth. If you got some quarters in the bottom of your purse and you need to be clean them out, give them to the children and let them bring Wednesday night, all right? Also, the drive will end July 26th. That's the close to the end of the month. And so here's the thing. After 2 days of collecting, I can't believe this. After 2 days of collecting, the teens are leading. The teens, I can't believe that, because they don't want to give nobody nothing. But the teens are leading, and so I got to get the babies back on top. Last week, the baby was on top last week, so I got to get John Michael some more money, all right? Listen, last but certainly not least, the back-to-school bash lock-in will be Friday, July 31st. Listen, we are excited about that also, and we got permission slips available today at the Welcome Center. The forms and the fee are due, all right, by the third Sunday in July. The forms and fee will due, and I want our children use this as an outreach mechanism. You have some guys that you go to school with that may not go to church. We want you to invite them to the lock-in, all right? I want you to invite them to the lock-in, and so we'll have information for that in the foyer also at the Welcome Center. Also, here's what I need you to do. There will be no forms or no money taking that check-in, so you can't decide at the last minute, but that Dooboo gonna go that day, all right? We need you, because we gotta get a calendar. We got some activities that are going to transpire, so we need you to do that. Also, last but certainly not least, we need donation of school supplies and hygiene will be accepted on Wednesdays and Sundays at the Welcome Center. Everything at the Welcome Center, okay? All right? All right, and so anyone interested in being a sponsor, you can see any member of the youth ministry, and they will be glad for that. All right, I think that's all I had at this time. There was a whole lot, but it needed to be said, and so I thank God for each and every one of you. At this time, we're going to prepare our hearts and our mind to give unto the Lord that which he has given unto us, and we want you to remember what we are doing as far as what we're trying to achieve here. We want you to give something to our building fund. Also, today is First Sunday. Brother Will and Brother Grant, you will get extra baskets for our fellowship fee, $1 fellowship fee today that we will take up today. And I thank God for you and all that you continue to do. At this time, we want to ask that our ushers and our officers prepare. Deacon will come and lead us in prayer. The choir will give us a ministry in music. And because I know you're full of pork and your head hurting, I'm going to let you go early today. And we are excited about what God is about to do in our life. I want to say this. Brother Walker is not here. Brother Willie Walker is not here, but he is a deacon candidate. And it's a blessing to know people in, I wouldn't say high places, but in the right place. And so Deacon candidate Willie Walker has informed us that in the next couple of months, there will be a donation that will come, and we'll tell you about that later, but the donation will be 225 passenger buses, free. Y'all didn't hear what I said. I said, donate it. Y'all still missed it. I said, 225 passenger buses. Two 25 passenger buses. And that's going to really help us out. We have children that we need to get here on Wednesday night and Sunday. And so that's going to be a blessing. We got plenty of CDL licensed drivers in the building. And so we're going to be utilizing the Tuckers and the Grants and all these folk that got CDL, all right? And so God is moving in a marvelous way. And so we thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. All right, Deacon.
Good Master, we come to say thank you. Thank you for being such a wonderful God, for blessing us right now. We ask, O merciful Father, that you would, we would continue to bless him by giving him, merciful Father. It is truly a blessing to give, to be able to give. Bless those that give, Father. Bless those that wanted to give and didn't have it, O merciful Father. Bless them in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
All right, at this time, we will stand on my left and my right, and the usher will direct you around as you come to get your tithe and your offering at this time. If you need to give online, you can go to obctuscaloosa.org. Those of you that are streaming live, you can go to obctuscaloosa.org, and you can put your information in on the reference line. On the reference line, you can put whatever you wanted to go for, youth, whatever, et cetera, tithes, offering, wherever you wanted to go, we will make sure that it gets there, all right? The choir will give us some music as you come to give the tithe and the offering.
For the things
Thank you so very much. Forgot to mention doing announcements, our choir and their pastor will be in concert. What's the date? 24th of July in Montgomery, Alabama. And we thank God for that opportunity at the New Life Baptist Church. Our very good friend, Pastor Charles Thomas, and our good friend, Joffrey Moore, is hosting us. And we thank God for God opening doors for us and our music ministry. And so we're looking, that's on a Friday night, right? It's on a Friday evening. And so it's at 7:00. And so we'll put the address up if you want to go with us. But we're looking forward to that. Listen, it's prayer time, and we are so grateful for God smiling on us and allowing us the activity of our limbs. I do want to say we got a very important call at work yesterday, and the office phone does not ring on the weekend. I decided to answer, and it was Reverend Dr. W.J. Long, and he said, "Jeff, I've been trying to reach you. I've been sick. I've been in the hospital. I've had surgery, but I just thought you needed to hear that I support the work that you're doing." Isn't that wonderful? Isn't that wonderful? And he and Sister Long will be to see us in a couple of weeks. And so it's humbling to me for a man to be his age and to look at the work that we're trying to do and understand that it's not about Jeff Thompson, but it's about the God that we serve. And so as we come to the altar, we want to remember him today, and then all sick and shut in, want to remember those that are bereaved. We know families are grieving all over Tuscaloosa about tragic loss of loved ones. And just want to pray for everybody. Want to thank God for Sister Sharon Welch, and went before the board and got a favorable report. And I was in an ethics, I was in an ethics meeting. One of the doctors who's on the board said, "I know your member." I said, "Yeah." And he said, "I don't know what y'all doing in Tuscaloosa, but whatever y'all doing, y'all keep doing it." I said, "We just praying." And so we thank God. God is a prayer-answering God. I said he's a prayer-answering God. And at this time, I want you to come to the altar and bring your needs, bring your burdens unto the Lord. And come believing that whatever you need from God, he can do it. He can do it. He can do it. You need your children saved, he can do that. You need your body healed, he can do that. You need him to make ways out of no ways, he can do that also. You need a wave of children to come back home, he can do that. We got to ask it in faith. He said, "Ask and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock, and the door shall be open," right? And so as we come to the altar, Deacon Pruitt is going to come and lead us in prayer as we approach the throne of grace.
Father God, it's once again that we come, your children, we come to you, Father, as a little child. We come, Father, just being so thankful for this moment. Because, Father, we realize, Father, that it is you that have given us this opportunity. And, Father, we just want to just give you the praise right now while we have that opportunity. We want to thank you, Father, for your mercy and your grace for enabling us to be here. Father, we just want to pray for those that are going through some sickness, O merciful Father. We know, Father, that you said in your word that you want all of us to prosper spiritually and in good health, Father. So most of all, Father, we want to ask that we are spiritually fed. And then, Father, you said in your word, by your Christ, we are healed. So, Father, we just pray right now in the name of Jesus that whatever sickness that we have, whether it's cancer, whether it's kidney, we just pray the blood of Jesus over that situation. Because we know, Father, that you are a great healer. You are the great I am. You are all that we need. And we just give it all to you, Father. Coming to you in faith and believing that you will do what you say you'll do. That you can't do nothing. You can't fail, O merciful Father. And we're just giving our situation over to you. Some of us may be going through some problems with our family life, children, husband. We're just asking, O merciful Father, that you would just touch that child's heart, Father, and let them know, give them an obedient spirit, Father, that they will obey their elders, no matter who it may be, Father. And especially praying that they will honor their parents in all their ways, Father. And then, Father, though someone that's dealing with their husband or wife, Father, we pray the blood of Jesus over that situation. We know that you are a peacemaker, O merciful Father. You are all that we need, Father. And we just ask and pray, Father, that you would just bring peace within that family where there's confusion. Father, we ask that you would be with us as we go out in the highways, O merciful Father, and help us to spread your word to a dying generation. Help us, Father, to be that child, that Christian, who you want us to be, Father. Not only here at church, but everywhere we may go, Father. Help us to shine our light, Father. Shine our light that someone would see us. Someone that's in darkness will see a light in us and want to be saved, Father, want to come to the marvelous light. You said in your word, Father, that if we lift you up, that you will draw all men unto you. Sometimes we get confused and we want to draw men, but our job is to lift you up, Father. And then someone would see our light. Let us let our light shine everywhere we go, Father. And then, Father, I continue to ask a mighty blessing upon each and every family member here, each and every member here, Father. Father, you know the blessing that they need. So we ask that you would just bless them in the name of Jesus. Continue to bless this leader of this great church, Father. Fresh, anoint him afresh, Father. Strengthen him where he's weak. Build him up where he's torn down. Father, continue to give him a word for this church, for each member, that we will grow each and every day, that we won't leave here the same as we came. We will leave here more confident, more faithful than when we came, Father. Father, we just want to give you the praise and give you the honor. Because, Father, it's all about you. It's all about you, Father. We want to tell you we love you. We praise you. We give you all the honor because you so deserve it. And we thank you for your son, Jesus, who died for all our sins. Because without him, Father, there was no hope. But through him, you, Father, we have eternal life. And we thank you, Father. We thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Come on, thank God for answer prayer. Amen. Lord, do Lord, do it, Lord, do it, Lord.
Lord, do it.
Do it for me.
Do it for me.
Right now. Lord, do it.
Lord, do it.
Lord, do it.
Lord, do it for me.
Oh, do it for me.
Do it for me. Right now.
If you read the Bible, I know you read the story. About a blind man who could not see.
Yeah.
But one day, he heard Jesus were passing by. He said, lay your hands on me. Lord, do it.
Lord, do it.
Well, how many need him to do something for you today? Lord, do it. Do it, yeah. It's coming from your peace you give me in time of the storm. You are
the source of my strength. You are the strength of my life.
One more time. Witness in the house, you are the source of my strength.
You are
the strength.
The strength.
Yeah, yeah. You are the source of my strength. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You are.
I declare if you praise him, you'll feel better. You are. Come on, one more time. Oh, you are.
You are.
You are.
The joy of my
life. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You are.
You are.
You are.
You're
the strength. God praise. Hallelujah. 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 You ought to thank God for being the source of your strength. Been the strength of your life. Hallelujah. Romans 8. Romans 8. Just one verse, verse 38. And this is all I want to say today. I'm going to let you go. Romans 8, 38 says, the New Living Translation says, and I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today or our worries about tomorrow. Not even, watch this, the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. I just want to talk for a minute from this thought. I'm persuaded. Paul says in Romans 8, he said a whole lot of stuff. Verse 31, he asks, what shall we say about these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? And he goes down to verse 33 and he talks about, he says what in verse 31, but then in verse 33 he says, who accuses us of whom God has chosen for his own? No one. And then in verse 34 he talks about who will condemn us. Then in verse 35, he asks a very important question. Can anything separate us from God's love? And then he quoted the scripture in verse 36. And then he said in verse 37, despite all the stuff I just told you, we still have victory in Christ because
He loved us. And then here's where we need to get. Because if you had not been persuaded, oh my God, that nothing shall separate you from the love of God, then you will allow folk to send you to hell. But I believe I got about 25 folk in the building that say, listen, I've been walking with him long enough. I've been talking with him long enough. He's taken care of my children. He's paid my bills. I'm persuaded. I don't need another sermon. I don't need another praise. Listen, I already am persuaded.
Like how you said in verse 38, and I don't have time to deal with this because I feel the anointing that's present in this room. God wants to deliver today. He wants to set free, but you got to be willing to understand. Don't let what you did last night persuade you to thinking that he does not love you. Oh my God. Nothing can separate us. Love. He said, okay, if you don't think that's true, he said, well, what if you die? Can that separate us from the love? No, Paul, I got scripture to back that up because the psalmist said, listen, if I get some wings and fly to the othermost part of the world, he's still there. If I go to hell, he's there too. There's no way that I can get from God. So you can't be separated by when you die. You have to spend eternity. And then Paul said, well, I tell you what, if death don't do it, what about the angels? Can they separate? No, because when he comes back for us, watch this. We are so meticulous and we are so special in God's eyesight that he ain't going to send no angels. He said, I'm going to come myself. He said, listen, no, you, these are my children. I don't send folk to do what I can do for myself. In other words, these are my children, and my name is on them, and so I ain't going to allow no angel to do it. But watch this. Paul said, okay, all right. So the death won't get you. So the angels, he said, well, what about demons? Watch this. What I like about demons is that this, listen, they can't stay around where you call in the name of Jesus. In other words, the Bible says that at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue must confess. If they don't do it but one time, when Jesus is around, they got to confess that he's around. Said, no, so no demons won't get it. Okay, Paul, but what about if I'm scared, if I'm fearful? Listen, ain't nothing wrong with being scared. It's all right. It just means that you are in touch with your feelings. There's nothing wrong with you being afraid because you've never been as spiritual as you are now, and so you are afraid. Yesterday at the cookout, you weren't drinking no more, and you weren't smoking no more, and you weren't talking about folk no more, and your folks said you were acting funny. But you need to understand that what has happened is that you've grown up since last year, and your appetite has changed. In other words, you understand that I have Jesus in my heart, and so wherever I go, I gotta be careful how I take him and how I represent him. So he says, watch this, okay? If you don't have to worry about anything, you feel anything. He said, well, what about the day? What about the day? But then watch this, not worry about what about tomorrow? I got scripture to back that up because one day they asked Jesus for manna. They asked God for manna. The Old Testament, and God said, okay, I'm going to allow matter to come, but what I want you to do is I got specific instructions. He said, now, I'm going to feed you, but what I want you to do is just get enough for the day. And so, watch this. When God allowed the manna to come down, they start calling Pookie and Ray Ray and tell them they're giving away free food stamps. Y'all better come down here and get this commodity meat, this commodity cheese. And watch this. They didn't trust God. They went to bed. They put it up under their knapsacks. They put it up under their pillows. They went to sleep thinking that they had gotten over on God. But the next day, watch this, because God requires us to trust him day by day.
day. Give us our daily bread. God said, listen, when they woke up the next morning, all the extra food was spoiled. In other words, what I'm trying to tell you is, if God took care of you yesterday, watch this. You have to have enough faith that he'll take care of you today.
Let me close with this. But watch this. Paul said, okay. We ain't got to worry about today. We ain't got to worry about tomorrow. Then he said, but what about the powers of the devil? What about hell? What do we have to worry about that? No. I got scripture to back that up too, Paul. The Bible says that one day Lazarus and the rich man died. And the Bible says that both died on the same day. I can imagine in my sanctified mind, because Lazarus was poor, nobody showed up at his funeral. Nobody planned his funeral. They just probably just put him in a grave and buried him. But everybody was at the rich man's funeral because he was rich and everybody knew him. And so he had many people to stand and give reflections on his program. But can I tell you something? I don't care how many folks stand and give reflections on your behalf. If you ain't done it before you close your eyes, it's too late. Watch this. What about hell? What about hell? Well, the Bible says that the rich man and Lazarus died. The rich man, watch this, went to hell. And Lazarus, watch this, went to a form of heaven. In other words, the Bible says that this scene happens where we see the rich man and Lazarus. Watch this. Lazarus was in the bosom of Abraham. And the Bible says that a great gulf separated, watch this, where the rich man was and where Lazarus was. And the rich man had a conversation, say, listen, God, can I go back and tell my brothers? Can I go back and tell them that they needed? No, they had ample opportunity. Listen, you got to understand that all of us have a destination. You can choose you this day whom you're going to serve. The Bible says that the gulf separated them. And the rich man told Lazarus, say, listen, it's hot down here. It's getting hot in here. Somebody take off all my clothes. Watch this. Because it's hot down here. Matter of fact, he said it like this. He said, Lazarus, can you come and dip my finger? Dip your finger in the water and cool my tongue. Because I'm tormented. I'm burning where I am. And so I need somebody to go back and tell them that this thing is real. I need you to understand today that I don't care what the media says. I don't care what scientists said. I don't care what astrologers say. Listen, there is a heaven and there is a hell, and you will spend eternity at one of those locations. Watch this. You got to be careful that you're always working on your address. Oh, my God. That's why I don't get upset about same-sex marriages. That's why I don't get upset about the Confederate flag, because I'm just a pilgrim passing through. It don't matter to me, because where I'm going ain't no Confederate flags, ain't no black and white. It's just Jesus.
Watch this. So I'm done. If all that can't separate you from the love of God, then there are people under the sound of my voice. What are you waiting on? Anything that you have done, watch this, in your past, and anything that you are doing in your present, and anything that you will do in your future, what if I tell you that it's already been paid for? What if I told you it don't matter how much weed you smoke, don't matter how much you sold, how much crack you did, how much cocaine you did, how many women you slept with, how many men? What if I told you that even in the midst of that, God still loves you? What if I told you that? The reality of the matter is, we got to get persuaded that no matter what y'all jumping up and down and mad with the homosexuals and the lesbians for? Why you dogging folk out when your stuff tore up? The newspaper called me and said, we want you to do a comment about I have no comment.
I have no comment, because there's some stuff that folk know about Jeff Thompson that you don't know. Oh, y'all. From the past. In other words, what I'm saying is, why not be persuaded to offer people, watch this, God's love? It's amazing to me that we get in the kingdom of God and we get saved and we get filled with the Holy Ghost, and then we don't want nobody else saved. I can't be around that, honey. No, I'm Holy Ghost filled. Well, it was just last week you were around there taking a charge. What if I told you? You got to be persuaded. Persuaded. Believe it in your heart that nothing you have done has disconnected you from God. Yeah, folk will disconnect themselves from you. But God say, nothing you have done, I'm going to still love you. What I like about God, he's just like mamas. Mamas are special. Because mamas going to love you when nobody else loved you. That's how God is. Mamas will go in the courtroom, pay child support, get another job to keep you out of jail. Mamas will go with you the extra mile. That's how God is. You know what he's doing right now when the door is open? You know what he's doing for you? Because I feel God's presence in this place. This message was just for you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. You have been persuaded by everybody else. They persuaded you to do all kind of stuff. I want to tell you that you need to be persuaded that God loves you in spite of your past, in spite of your present, and in spite of your future. Now, let me tell you. Let me talk about the future, because some people are saying, oh, since I got saved, I don't sin no more. Well, I'm scared of you. You do everything right, since I'm scared of you. Paul said, the things that I should do, those are the things that I don't do. And the things that I don't have any business doing, those are the things. He said, oh, wretched man that I am. In other words, as long as you in this, you're going to have some stuff that you need to work on. But watch this. What if I told you, watch this. What if I told you this? I'm done. Somebody need to move. You need to come and be persuaded. I'm telling you, I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you, my brother. I'm talking to you, my sister. Listen, you need to come while the blood is running warm. I'm trying to persuade you that no matter what the devil has sold you, God has better for your life. How many more folk got to die in the car wreck? How many more folk got to die in the hot? How many more folk in your class got to die for you to be persuaded that you got to leave here? Why you living like you ain't got to leave? I want to persuade you today. Why don't you trust God? Why don't you trust God? What else is it going to take for you? He's made ways out of no way. Why is he still keep? Why? Matter of fact, watch this. Why everybody else done got caught but you hadn't? It ain't that you ain't doing it. It's because somebody is interceding for you. The door is open as the choir sings. As the choir sings, come by letter, candidate, baptism, or by Christian experience. The door is open for you. Be persuaded today. Be persuaded today. On my left, on my right, in the middle, in the balcony. Be persuaded. I am persuaded. The door is open. Door is open for you. For a saint. For a saint. Who fell down? If you're afraid to walk, tell your neighbor, walk with me, take me down. I'm persuaded that God loves me no matter what I've done. I am persuaded. But we get up, we fall. But we get up, we fall. But we get up. For a saint, we're waiting on you. We're waiting on you. We're waiting on you.
gotta.
Come on, one more time, one more time.
We fall down.
We fall down.
But we get up.
We fall down.
We get up.
We fall down.
But we get up.
For a saint.
Come on, one is coming.
We fall, but we get up.
Come on, is there another?
For a saint is just a
sinner
who fell down.
Get back up
and
get up.
Come on, the door's open.
You can get back up again.
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 Run to his arms.
Run to his arms. For a saint, for a saint.
Who fell
and got up.
Every eye closed, every head bowed. Father, we love you and we thank you for this worship experience, and we thank you for your anointing, and we thank you for the clarion call that has gone out. God, you're moving on the altar of three people hard in this room. God, we pray as we are praying that you let them know it's all right. The street may know what they have done, but they need to be persuaded that you love them in spite of. And so, God, right now we ask that you give them strength to get up out of their seat, make up their mind, and be persuaded that you love them. And we'll be careful to give your name glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, clap those hands and give them praise. Now, do it now. Do it now. Somebody need to move. There are three of you. There are three of you. We fall down, but we get up.
We fall.
There are three of you in this room. Come on, make up your mind.
We fall, but we get up.
For a saint,
for a saint.
Come on. Come on. Come on. I don't care what you've done. I don't care what you've done. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
You can get back up again.
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 Run to his arm.
Run to his
arm for a saint.
Clarion call, one has answered, and we thank God for this one. Come on, give God praise in this place. All right, Sister Cotton is coming by letter. Amen. Thank you. God, God bless you. Let's say that you're going to join this church, and you're going to be done by the Lord. Welcome you to the church, and we thank God for you making up your mind. Listen, those three people, listen. I'm telling you this. You ain't going to have no rest this week. You ain't going to rest this week. Whatever you thought you were going to do, you ain't going to be able to do it, because you're going to be thinking about you should have got up. Yeah, you're going to do it. All right.
right? I'm just speaking what thus says the Lord. God say, listen, make up your mind now.
Look it up. 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 My God. That's the best y'all can do when God speak in the place of. My God. My God. Look at that. That's God. Look at God. Look at God. They are running. They are running. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, my God. Wait a minute. I hear something else. God say some men. There are some men that need, some young men. Some young men need to come down. Make up your mind. The time is right. The time is right. The time is right. The time is right. Hallelujah. 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 For a saint is just a sinner who fell down and got up. Come on. We fall down. We fall. Come on, the Spirit is still moving. We fall. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. Today is your day. Today is your day. Come while the blood is still running warm in your veins. Make up your mind for a thing. Come on, make up your mind. Come on, my brother. Come on, make up your mind. Make up your mind. Come on, make up your mind. Come on. Come on, let God move on your heart. We fall down, but we get up. Yeah, yeah. Come on, somebody else need to move. Somebody else need to move. Come on, don't be afraid. Be persuaded. Come on, get on the right side today. Come on, come on.
Experience. God bless you. Stand. We have Sister Cooper, who's coming under Christian Experience. And we have Sister Linda Gardner, who is coming under Christian Experience. God bless you. Bless all of you. Thank you for being obedient to the Spirit of God. Amen. Listen, we're going to stand and go. But I tell you what, I'll say what I said before. You ain't going to rest. This week, you got to come. Let us stand. Let us stand.
Let's pray. We love you. We praise you. Your name is above every name in the earth, man. God, we thank you for using every person from the start to the finish of this worship experience. God, we thank you for the souls that you have sent our way. And then we thank you for the souls that are on the way. Anoint, appoint, purify, sanctify our hearts and our minds to receive what you have done in this room today. That husband, that wife, that son, that daughter, that's worried about situations that's going on in their life. I heard God say, peace would surpass all understanding. That in the midst of chaos, you will have peace on your job and in your home. Peace will abide. When you walk in the room, you'll bring peace. Wherever you go, peace will abide. Wherever you tread, peace will abide. Right now in the name of Jesus. And it is so. And we claim victory over our situations and our circumstances. God, we thank you for every home and heart that's represented here. And we pray from the youngest to the oldest, from the wisest to the foolish, that you will bless and keep us as only you can. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty both now and forevermore. Let us all say amen. Come on, hug somebody and tell them you love them. There's nothing they can do about it.